Hi everyone, and welcome back to Creative PowerPoint. Today, let's make together this rocket launch animation. To make the rocket, I reused a standard icon. From the icons menu of the insert ribbon, I choose a solid rocket. Then I converted it to shapes by using the convert to shape menu of the graphics format ribbon. Then I merge the various parts into a single shape. Go to shape format, merge shapes and select union. Once this is done, just rotate the rocket. Hold the shift key to rotate it in increments of 15 degrees. The rocket being rotated, it's not easy to resize it. Let's reset the rotation value. Create a rectangle over the rocket and move it to the back. Select the rectangle, hold the shift key and click on the rocket to add it to the selection. Then in the shape format tab, select intersect. It has intersected the rocket with the rectangle, and so we end up with the rocket.
Is this stupid?
Not really. We now see that the rotation has been reset and the rotation handle is now at the top. This is because PowerPoint reused the rotation angle from the rectangle. And it's now much easier to resize the rocket. Let's set a fill color and remove the rocket outline. To create the smoke, I reused some icons to make our life easier. From the icons menu of the insert ribbon, I chose a solid cloud. In the graphics format tab, I selected convert to shape. I duplicated the cloud multiple times, rearranged the copies to form the smoke shape. With the cloud selected, I went to shape format tab, under merge shapes, selected union. I set a fill color and removed the outline. Then I duplicated the smoke and flipped it horizontally. I added a path animation for both of them. With a duration of 4 seconds. And for both of them, I removed the smooth start and end. I added a white rectangle to hide the bottom of the smoke, then a gray rectangle for the ground. Here's the animation so far. Let's add the countdown. Let's insert a text box with a 3. For this text box, we'll add 3 animations. Add one zoom animation for the entrance. Add a grow animation with a factor of 1500%. Finally, add a fade out animation. For the timings, we want the zoom to last 0.5 seconds and the grow and fade out to take place at the same time for a duration of 1 second. Do the same for the numbers 2 and 1, adding an extra delay of 1 second every time. Let's animate the rocket takeoff. We want an effect that animators call squash and stretch. Let's see this in slow motion. The rocket starts by squashing and stretches to the side. And then after the jump, it takes its initial dimensions again. Here's the animation at normal speed. To do so, let's duplicate the slide. Let's remove the smoke, the white background and the numbers on the new slide. Let's make a second copy of this new slide. On slide 2, let's squash the rocket. Let's also stretch the rocket. Hold the command key while resizing it to pin the object center. On slide 3, let's just move the rocket to the slide center and move the ground object below the slide. Now select slides 2 and 3 and add a morph transition. Slide 2 duration is 0.1 second, and it should move to the other slide after 0 seconds. Slide 1 moves automatically to the next slide after 4 seconds. Here's the animation so far. For the stars, I just inserted rounded rectangles, added them over multiple places, and merged them into one single shape. Then I moved them below the slide and added a flying animation from the top. I duplicated this shape with various delays and durations to add a parallax effect. Before it goes out of scope, the rocket does another scratch and stretch. We can't use the morph transition here, as it would conflict with the star animation. So let's add regular PowerPoint animations here. First, let's add a path animation for the retreat movement. Then add a flyout animation to the top. Then for the scratch and stretch, let's add a grow animation, but this time, let's set different values for the horizontal and vertical stretched. Horizontally, we'll set a stretch value of 150%. Let's add another grow animation, but this time, we'll set a vertical stretch value of 75%. Then, when the rocket moves forward, it scratches and stretches in the other dimensions. We'll simply add two grow and shrink animations, one with the horizontal stretch value of 50% and the other one with a vertical stretch value of 200%. The final part is a text-shaped video. For this, I'm using a trick explained by Wenskill a few weeks ago on his YouTube channel. I'll give the link in the video description. Don't hesitate to check his video and subscribe to him. This guy makes fantastic tutorials. For our text, I'm using this video of outer space I found on Pexels. I'll give the link in the description. Let's insert the video. And let's add a text. To merge the text and the video, we need to add the merge shape menu to our quick access toolbar. Go to the PowerPoint preferences and add the merge shape option to the quick access toolbar. Save the preferences. Once this is done, select the video, hold the shift key and click on the text to add it to the selection. Then, in the quick access toolbar, under the new merge shapes shortcut, select intersect. Just make sure the video is set to playback automatically. Add a flying effect from the top. Adjust the order and the timings of the animations. Our job is complete. Let's see our finished animation.